6.
All right, now
368-3756.
Ask about the Hugs event on Friday night. On Thursday, I'll be honored to be able to be the MC of the Girls and Boys Club at Country Club of Ocala. That's a great event, and they do a terrific job, and I'll be out there on Thursday. So we've got a busy week, and tomorrow we'll be at the Willie Nelson
concert. We'll be at Willie Nelson tomorrow.
And Sunday we'll be out at the
Super Bowl. Now next Saturday I'm going to be at Mojo's Grill and Catering Company.
Mm-hmm. You're going to eat, right?
No, actually, you know, my father was a Marine,
mm-hmm.
and so I very passionate about the Marine Corps. I'm passionate about our military, that they allow us to be free by their sacrifices. Well, there's going to be a welcome home dinner for Lance Corporal Davis Garrett Burgess, and it's $20 a ticket. It includes dinner and a soft drink. It's February 8th at 6 p.m. It's at the Pine Avenue location, the old Mojo's. It's not at the new Mojo's. It's at the old Mojo's on Pine Avenue.
Is that a restaurant now still?
Well, Mojo's uses it as a special event location.
Oh, okay. I got you.
The one next to the police department.
Okay.
It's at 6 p.m. This is what's great. Mojo's is supplying all the food, all the setup and everything. All the proceeds from this go to Lance Corporal David Garrett Burgess's family, because he's wounded.
Yeah.
And he's coming. He is not able to. He doesn't have full function anymore. So all the proceeds from this benefit will go to help his family.
Great cause.
Great cause.
And again, thanks to Rondo.
Right.
Again, one of my top 10 people last year in Ocala, I picked Rondo because of things just like that.
Right.
Because it's big heart. So
if you want more information, you can go to facebook.com events, and then the number for the event is, it's kind of a lengthy number, but it's 207-458-682-776-026. But you just call Mojo's and they'll tell you about the event.
Yeah.
But it's next Saturday night, 6 p.m. I'll be there for that.
All right. I want to get to the story, because this is my new feature called Buddy's Tip Sheet. Okay? This is good stuff here. I got four or five things you can use and make a note of it. Just little short things, and I think it'll help you in some of the things. Some of them are informational, some of them are essential, some of them are not essential. But here's one I tried. See, if you have a stuffy nose, push your tongue against the roof of your mouth, press the finger between the eyebrows, repeat in 20 seconds. That will open up your nose.
Really?
The reason I know, you know, I've had a little bit of a sniffle
you
last
do.
Couple of days. It worked for me. Again, push your tongue against the roof of your mouth, then press your finger between your eyebrows, and say how long, and then repeat in 20 minutes. It'll open up your passages.
Did it work for you?
It did this morning, this afternoon, earlier. So, number two, now this is a really good one. You go online, you buy stuff, right? And you order it, and you say, enter the promo code. Guess what?
It never works.
Never got any proof.
Never.
You know what you can do? Google for the promo code, and you can get it online and get up to 25% off.
Really?
Yes, that's according to my sources from, my sources. Just Google it, and you'll get the promo code. Ask the promo code of the product, and slap it on there, and you'll get a discount. Here's another one. You know, sometimes you have things you want to get rid of, and you don't want to sell on eBay, but they are worth things. What do you do with them? Well, sometimes you can barter things.
Okay.
Books, clothes, DVDs, home repairs, and it's supposedly relatively easy to do that. People who share a similar interest, especially on Facebook now, and there's sites called meetup.com, u-exchange.com, and babysitterexchange.com, which you can swap out babysitting services for product, etc. Apparently this is something going on. A lot of people barter. So if you got things you don't need and you want to get rid of them, if you don't want to give them to charity, you trade them out. Barter. Again, meetup.com, uexchange, u-exchange.com. There's one called babysitterexchange.com. So you can swap for babysitting services with product. Here is a non-essential something. Just in case you're ever in Japan, there are owl cafes there, OW, owl cafes, where you can pet and play with live owls while enjoying a nice meal. How about
okay.
that? There you go. That's probably high on your priority, isn't it?
It's not something I really want to do, but okay.
Now, here's an important one. Passwords.
Yes.
You probably have your same old passwords.
I do.
All right? And you probably have the same one for most every account.
I have one password that I use for every account.
All right, you and Josh, you just rolled in here. I'm going to give you a list of passwords. If you got these, get rid of them. They're easy to hack. All right, you ready? First one is 123456.
No,
get rid of it if you're using it, okay? The second one is
password.
Yeah, password.
People.
Right. Another one is QWERTY. Why? Because it's all on the keyboard right together.
Well, it's the first six letters.
QWERTY.
It's the first six letters
on
the left side.
You don't want to do QWERTY. Then do not use ABC123.
No.
All right? And then a couple others. Do not use 111111. That's a bad one.
Yes.
Do not use I love you.
Mm. Okay.
Do not use Adobe 123. Now, that's what I've been thinking about. We get Adobe 123. Do not use admin, ADMIN. Do not use let me in. Is this boring you, Tom?
Yeah, well, none of these have even come close to my password.
1234. I bet you got one someplace.
Nope.
I'll confess I've had that one in some of my passwords.
I've never had it.
All right. Shadow, sunshine, princes.
Nope.
Pet names.
And 0000000. Pet names are okay as long as you know. That's okay. Especially if you had like a number at the end.
Well, I use.
Don't say what you
do. No, I'm not going to say what.
Give us your password,
Look,
Tom. Go ahead.
My
See,
bank
y'all
PIN
stop.
Number.
Y'all just assume that's what I was going to say.
Mm-hmm.
I use capitals, numbers, and lowercase.
Good, that helps.
All in my password.
That helps me. I'm hacking in your account.
Yeah,
right?
You should.
Yeah. So this little password. So there you are, the tip sheet. All right?
Right.
A little something for you to use. I've got a couple that I have. I have different passwords. I've changed some of mine. But I got some funky numbers in there that are pretty easy to solve. So I got to go home and work on that. And by the way, change your password every 6 months. If you can't, then you got to figure out how in the world am I going to be able to remember it.
Exactly.
I put mine in my phone. And then I can go find it.
That's what I do. I put mine in my phone. But I use the same exact password
for everything.
For everything, but I'm able to change it. And I change it every 2 or 3 months.
Okay.
Even though it's the same password.
All right. I just say don't do that, but that's just a... Anyway, we got that. Today we got something called Captain Obvious. We'll take a break, come back. Tom's got a Captain Obvious. I've got a tweets and quotes for you. And hour one is under wraps, and we'll go next hour talking to Jim Ross of the Star Banner and get Jim Ross to play Fake or Factoid with us. What do you think?
Okay.
All right. Stay tuned to the Voice of Ocala. It's Community Gazette Day at the Gateway Bank right here on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA. The source.
Marsh Bank approval. Vehicle purchase price of fixed rate allowance.
Don't pump iron. Dump it.
Chris Spears here from Prestige Auto Sales with the health and beauty secret of the new year. The fastest way to look great in 2014 is to dump your old car. Lose that old car weight of a car you hate. Bring me your old car, and based on the sale price of the nicer, newer car you choose, I'll give you up to $5,114 off a nicer, newer car today. Look good right away in a nicer, newer car today and get up to $5,114 off.
Plus, our For the People credit approval process gets the lender sweaty and ready to approve you, even if you've had credit problems in the past.
Kick off your old car diet today.
See you at Prestige.
But wait, get here fast. My old car diet program ends after we've helped 47 people drop the weight of the car they hate.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales or call 694-1234. Yes, 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
If you missed Dr. Buddy recently, you missed Dr. Buddy's advice on what women should do when they found out they've been cheated on by their man.
What to do after D-Day recommends take time off. Going away for a while, with or without children, helps you gain clarity. Take a few days off from work. If that's not possible, go away for a weekend. Even if you can only afford to go down the street to a friend's house, the personal time is worth it. So that's the one from E. Langro. Another one from E. Langro says, after this has happened to you, and you found out your husband is cheating on you, surround yourself with people who love you. Ask for help and support from your parents, siblings, and friends right away. Don't be afraid to ask of what anyone might think, because this situation is not your fault. This one comes in from Lonely from Him. Learn to say no. You're under extreme stress, but the rest of your life, job, kids, friends, won't calm down. Prioritize your responsibility so you can put some of them on the back burner. Start to tell people, I will have to deal with this low priority issue later.
Make sure you tune in to Dr. Buddy every Monday on the Voice of Ocala.
The Usual Suspects Jazz Quartet will be in Arthur's Bistro at the Hilton Hotel on February 1st from 6:30 till 9:30 p.m. And then on February 15th, Arthur's Bistro will be having a gala Valentine show with The Usual Suspects featuring guest vocalist Mark Raich from 6:30 till 9:30 p.m. for your dining, dancing, and listening pleasure. Based on previous performance, we recommend that you make a reservation for the show. Call 352-390-1515 for The Usual Suspects Jazz Quartet.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. You don't have to sacrifice convenience for local personal service.
At Florida Credit Union, you can transfer your high credit card balances to our rewards card and actually get paid with cash back. You'll enjoy low rates and a customizable card that fits your lifestyle for free.
Never tried a credit union? Maybe it's time for a new game plan.
The Florida Credit Union Wave Card, connecting your money to your life.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
A garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Ocala Radio, WOCA.
Back live at Gateway Bank for Community Gazette Day. It's time for a new segment. What are we calling this, buddy? Captain Obvious.
And we've been wanting to do this for weeks. it's going to actually be slow the first couple of times, but it will build.
I got a great.
You know why I know that? Because I know you're a one funny dude.
Oh, I got a great captain.
You should have been a stand-up comic in comedy, and you have awesome timing. So go ahead, Tom.
I got a great Captain Obvious day.
Yeah.
In the realms of duh. It is now a proven fact that in Russia,
yes,
they have linked drinking vodka to shorter lifespans.
Oh, no. So they juiced it up pretty good over there. Is that what you're saying?
Now the potato vodka that the Russians have been drinking so long, no wonder they can drink so much because they don't have to drink it until about 45 and they die, so it's no big deal.
There you go. If I say that qualifies as a Captain Obvious, for sure.
Yeah. They did an entire study. Took them 3.5 years of studying 14,000 Russians to see that drinking mass amounts of vodka shorten your lifespan.
Another Captain Obvious. If you have a Super Bowl in New York City, it's probably going to be cold.
Yeah.
There you go. So, all right, let's go little tweets and quotes here and get out of here in this hour. And if you'll fire up that music back there, there you go. Love you. Sing along if you're happy today. Number one, songs are life in 80 words or less. Neil Diamond.
Wow.
This comes from somebody named Jean de la Fontaine. A person often meets his destiny on the road he took to avoid it. And finally, from the late Norman Vincent Peale. I wish they stopped calling him Norman Peale. His name is not Norman Peale.
It's Norman Vincent Peale.
Oh, I've got to quote him on the internet. Norman Vincent, my late friend. Empty pockets never held anybody back. Only empty heads and empty hearts can do that. Coming back on the other side, we've got Jim Ross here. You know, Jim and I go back a ways.
Yeah.
He and I worked at the same newspaper at different times.
Right.
And it was the mothership. What a great newspaper to have been a part of. I know Jim will share that sentiment. And I was really proud of what they did with the Mariana story and the boys' school story about we read about the horrible thing that happened there. And thankfully, the Tampa Bay Times is there guarding and watching and things like that, and assisting public officials due diligence and getting USF involved. They uncovered 55 bodies at the backyard of that that school of
right.
Dozier up there. So
now, buddy, you know, on a totally different note, you know that I'm a food connoisseur. You know this.
No.
I've never met food I didn't like.
Some would say food connoisseur. Some might say hoggish. But go ahead.
Right. A buddy of mine sent me a recipe that I have to share with you. You know what? You know what cinnamon rolls, the Pillsbury cinnamon rolls?
Of course.
That,
I know
that
it.
That you bake in the oven?
It's like crack.
Well, my buddy now unrolls them. Mm-hmm. Out of the takes them out of the package, unrolls them flat, puts bacon in them, re-rolls them, and bakes them. It's
and
bacon cinnamon
oh,
roll.
Oh, my gosh. It is addictive. How could you not eat five of them?
A bacon cinnamon roll.
Let me ask you this. Does he eat any while he's cooking them?
Ooh.
Yeah, I think so, probably. All right, coming up next hour, we'll get fake and factoid. Jim Ross will be here with us. We'll talk about that. Many things to discuss on the Super Bowl. Coming up next, right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hey, it's Tom James. I agreed to join Buddy and the gang every Tuesday and Thursday at 5 o'clock to talk sports on the Voice of Ocala. We call it Around the Water Cooler. 1 hour to solve all the problems in the world of sports. Little did I know just how opposite our opinions would be. How can a group of guys see the same thing so differently? Some days I wonder if it's just water in that water cooler. Join Buddy, Schmitty, JJ, Austin, and me, Tom James, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 5. It's Around the Water Cooler on WOCA, The Source.
We're not just the horse capital of the world. Ocala Marion County is now the hoops capital, too, thanks to the 2013 national champion CF Patriots basketball team. The McDonald Allstate Agency brings you the reigning kings of the court all season long right here on WOCA. Coach Tim Ryan and the Patriots look to defend their national crown and get set to host the state tournament this coming spring. The McDonald Allstate Agency brings you CF basketball only on WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
This is Austin Tavern reminding you to stay in contact with us at WOCA. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Voice of Ocala. Make sure to become a friend of our Facebook page and call us at 622-9622.
Hi, I'm Angie Lewis. Let's talk every Tuesday afternoon on WOCA, the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Your home for CF Patriot basketball all season long. WOCA, The Source.
Howdy, RL here to tell you about a great deal at Dairy Queen. For only $4.49, you can warm up to a hot, juicy combo of either a foot-long, quarter-pound all-beef chili dog or a tasty home-style cheeseburger, smoking hot off the char grill. Both get fries and a drink. You can add a sundae for only 99 cents. Now that's a doggone good deal at Dairy Queen, Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing factory surcharge or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Yvette.
Burkett, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
In Southern California, well, there's something to it. The northern part of the state, too. It's dealing with one of the worst droughts on record now that the state's shutting off its water supply to agencies that serve millions of residents. Security can't be too tight for an event like the Super Bowl, and authorities got tested today on reports of a white suspicious powder that was found at several hotels near New Jersey's MetLife Stadium. At least one case turned out to be cornstarch. Super Bowl 48 may not be the coldest game at kickoff. The current forecast calls for 40 degrees. The Football Hall of Fame says it was 39 for the start of Super Bowl VI in New Orleans. Waiting on a response from the White House on a request to deport Justin Bieber, more than 220,000 people signed an online petition asking that he be sent back to Canada after his recent run-in with the law. The White House is required to respond to any petition that gets more than 100,000 signatures. This is ABC News.
Getting ready for that spring home makeover? Then get the hottest flooring styles for less at Lumber Liquidators Exotic Flooring Sale. Get hand-scraped exotic Brazilian cherry, hard-to-find acacia, and more, all on sale. You could pay $5.89 a square foot for Brazilian redwood at other stores, but we've got it for $3.99. That's 32% less. Plus, get high-quality laminates from 49 cents and special financing. Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com or your local store before these deals get away.
Minimum monthly payment required. Financing subject to credit.
It's kickoff time for the ultimate game, and there's no better time to build your ultimate sports cave at Rent-A-Center. Because right now, you'll find super deals on big screens, sofas, recliners, sound systems, and more with no credit check, just in time for kickoff. Plus, score a $10 Domino's Pizza promo card with any new agreement and first week's payment. Get to Rent-A-Center now in time for the ultimate game and this ultimate sports cave deal. Rental purchase transaction, limit one promotion card per customer. Offer ends 2/1/14. See store for details.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone? He's not gone! That's the whole point! He's never gone!
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei!
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
All right, welcome to hour two of the program. Live at Gateway Bank on a Friday. It's Community Gazette Day. Glad to be with you here. On this cloudy, overcast kind of day, rainy outside. Hopefully better weather this weekend, especially tomorrow. Tom and I will be heading over to Silver Springs to see Willie Nelson. And Tom, you're telling me they're expecting how many people?
10 to 12,000.
Wow.
You know, that's going to be
amazing.
I hope they're able to pull it off. It'll be a boon for Silver Springs. And
absolutely.
let's just hope that when we get there, we don't see some of the things we've heard we might see. Now, what does that mean? Well, I've heard that I've talked to some people that have been there that said they're not real happy with the condition, that it doesn't look like it's improved.
Oh, you
much.
Mean the springs or the venue?
Both.
Yeah, well, you know what?
I had a friend of mine yesterday that said they went a week ago, and there was still the dark green algae all over the place. Mm.
Now, you know the difference in you and the man we're going to have on in a couple of minutes. He actually makes you attribute those kind of remarks to somebody and some facts.
Well, I can attribute it to people, but then they'd get mad at me for saying their name on the radio.
If you're going to be a journalist, that's just how it is. You got to.
Yeah, but these people.
I'm not according to informed sources.
Yeah.
I won't work here.
I don't know if these are informed sources. Yeah. But
according to what I heard in the bar.
Yeah, exactly.
That night when I was about three sheets to the wind, I heard this. Well, yeah, it's going to be kind of interesting.
I could put that in my byline, you don't think?
You could. It wouldn't fit.
This according to what I was heard, what I was told in a bar at 12:30 in the morning.
You'd have a few of those stories. Coming up in just a couple of minutes, Jim Ross joins us. Jim is the new managing editor of the Star Banner, and he will be interested to hear his views about how he plans to cover the community. And Star Banner does a very good job, I think, of being with a limited staff today, and I know what that's like because having been on that side of it. You just can't cover everything you'd like to cover, so you have to rely upon citizens to help you out. And you have hardworking reporters, which, believe me, the hours add up fast. So we'll get Jim to tell us what kind of magic he's going to pull off at the Star Banner and talk a little more about that. On the Super Bowl front, Tom, I brought you a couple quotes on weather, because I know weather's a big deal right now, and people are talking about it. But my favorite quote on weather, this is an old, old, old one that goes back. If you apply it to the guy and where he actually played, what kind of conditions were, Vince Lombardi, right?
Right.
He was in the freeze bowl. Remember, he had
the ice bowl.
Yeah, an ice bowl. And Bart Starr comes off the field. They're at like the one-foot line against the Cowboys playing for the championship.
1967.
And he says, he says to Lombardi, I can move my feet and I can see the goal line. I think I can score. And so he says, well, then go do it. He didn't tell his running back what he was going to do, and he just shuffled in the end zone and won that game. But his famous quote, Lombardi's quote, is, weather is all in the mind.
That's probably very true, because we went into Appalachian State one year. We left Statesboro. We left Savannah on a charter plane. It was 84 degrees.
I thought you guys went on a Greyhound bus when you get an airplane.
No, we went from Greyhound from Statesboro to Savannah to the airport.
Okay.
Flew into Charlotte,
mm-hmm.
About 41 degrees. Got to Boone, North Carolina. It was 23 degrees. All we could think about the whole weekend, we lost that game 24-12, and all we could think about was
hot chocolate.
When are we going to get back on that plane and back to where it was 80 degrees?
You should have listened to the quote. Weather's all in the mind, so you've been okay.
We would have.
Eli Manning was asked about his brother's condition, about the cold weather Super Bowl, and asked whether it hurts Peyton or not. By the way, I have the forecast. It's not going to be that cold. And he said, I don't think this hurts or helps either team. Peyton has been in Denver this year and played outside in a lot of games, cold games. I think, obviously, if it were snowing or very windy, it could be a disadvantage to the Broncos because how much they like to throw the ball compared to Seattle in the running game. Remember yesterday I said I would pick the Seahawks if it's going to be inclement weather, because no matter what they said about Peyton, he played in a dome and he's been known as not being a good cold weather quarterback. Although he just played in Denver. So I don't think the weather is going to be a story, but boy, they've sure been talking about it all week long. Weather, weather, weather.
According to weather.com, the East Rutherford, New Jersey weather forecast at game time is a balmy 49 during the day. Mm-hmm. At kickoff, they think it'll be 39 degrees.
26 is low that night.
At 26, they think it'll be the low by midnight. Yeah, so by the end of the game, it should be about 26 degrees.
Yeah, so that's not bad, actually. So, I mean, in terms of by the time your body's all warmed up.
Right.
It's the ball that gets so hard.
Yeah.
Catching and kicking the ball, I can't tell you how hard it is in cold weather. I think receivers and quarterbacks will take rain over snow and cold any day. Because, of course, if you have the gloves now, it does help. But I tell you something else. I mentioned this. I've been in that stadium a lot of times to cover Giant games. And the wind currents are kind of funky in that stadium. You never know what they're going to do. But apparently the wind's not going to be a factor if the forecast is correct. Again, if the forecast is correct. And by the way, speaking of forecasts, I like the Broncos, but just barely
I'm taking the Broncos by a point over the Seahawks.
I got the Seahawks by a touchdown over the Broncos.
Yeah, well, we'll see. We'll get to cheer on for the Marion Theater on Sunday night. So, anyway, that's what's happening. Coming up in Sports Hour, Joe Williams will report to us from Denver. He'll get his take on what he thinks is going to happen to the Broncos. He's become an Elway sort of not a fan, but he tolerates Elway because he always liked to dog Elway all the time about we should trade him for Eric Dickerson. You know, oh, he's not that good a quarterback. When he finally did win a Super Bowl, I went out, I bought two John Elway jerseys, blue number sevens, and I made Joe Williams put that jersey on, and I put mine on, had our picture made, just to let him suffer a little bit. So tomorrow, on Sunday, in honor of Elway and Joe, I will wear my number seven blue jersey when I go down to actually cheer, since I'm not working for the Broncos. So that's what I'm doing. You can join us if you like. It's free.
It is free, and, beer, hot dogs, popcorn, and football.
Pretty hard to beat.
I don't see any way you can beat it.
Take a break. We come back. We have the new managing editor of the Star Banner, my friend Jim Ross, right here on the program, Voice of Ocala, live from Gateway Bank on a Friday on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Being out of the mall is actually pretty nice because we've got a resource center out there. Right. And in that resource center, we've got a program called Seniors Versus Crime. And it's been out there since 2007. And in that period of time, they've recovered over $354,000 of money back to crime victims. This past year, they helped 75 people get back about $90,000 worth of crime. And $90,000 worth of money, worth of funding. And mainly it's, these cyber crimes or scams that people run. Our elderly citizens get involved in it. They go out there and they're volunteers that actually do it, and they do the investigation there.
Make sure to tune in to Ask the Cops on WOCA, The Source. Dr. Seaborn Hunt, a board-certified ophthalmologist in Ocala. There's no referral needed for an appointment. Call 873-7200. Offering medical services for glaucoma management, including laser surgery to help lower your eye pressure and potentially reduce your dependency on eye drops. He also evaluates and treats diabetic retinopathy, one of the leading causes of blindness, with advanced imaging and laser procedure to help prevent vision loss. Dr. Hunt's office accepts most insurance and files claims for you. Call Dr. Hunt at 873-7200. That's 873-7200.
Hi, this is Brad. I want to take a moment to talk about a serious issue. In the next 5 years, the aviation industry is projected to have a shortage of commercial pilots. Now is the time to start training. Ocala Flying Club has started a scholarship for the youth of Marion County ages 17 to 24. The club will donate up to $4,000 towards a pilot's license. This will help get the student on their way to obtain their commercial pilot license. If this sounds like something you would be interested in, or if you know someone that would be, please contact Ocala Aviation Services, 861-7484.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. We're in Florida. Today, cloudy with a little rain and drizzle at times, high 68 to 72. Tonight will be mostly cloudy with a chance of a shower early, then some clearing late tonight. Lows ranging from 59 inland to 65 on the beaches. Tomorrow may start with areas of fog, otherwise clouds and some sunshine and warm with a chance of a shower, high 77 to 81. Sunday, partly sunny and warm, high 78 to 82. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe from Damage Control Services. Join me Tuesdays at 10:30 when we discuss what to do when your property gets damaged, how to fix it fast, and get back on track. At Damage Control, we specialize in helping home and business owners recover from damage caused by floods, fires, storms, tree damage, mold, and all other insurance-related disasters. So when disaster strikes, big or small, call Damage Control Services. Call me, 352-817-6574.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Friday at the Gateway Bank. We like to have informative programs and family guests and somebody who has just acceded to the throne of the Star Banner. Jim Ross joins us now. Congratulations on the job as managing editor. We had, if the producer was awake, he'd have
well,
the microphone.
Well, doing something else. The producer was supposed to do news, and you jumped in there.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, there you go. Want to give you news?
No, you came back without music then because we're right. Supposed to have news.
Okay. Well, anyway, I didn't want to be late, and I'm here. And
let's do it now.
Let's do it. Jim, how many years at the Star Banner now?
7 years.
Wow.
Yep.
You came directly from over in Citrus County to here?
That's right. The Citrus County Bureau closed end of March on a Friday. It was our last day of work. And Monday, I think April 2nd, was my first day at the Star Banner.
Mm. And had you had any working knowledge of Ocala prior to that?
I had. As you know, I've lived here since 1991. And I worked for the Times,
right.
As you mentioned before, but it was always in Citrus County, so I would just commute.
That's right. You lived here anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot. So, pretty easy transition for you.
Yeah, it was. It really was. I'd lived here for a long time, knew the community, knew a lot of people. My kids were all born here, and so it was very easy for me, and I was always a reader and fan of the Star Banner. And even as a journalist, I had come up here since I lived here. If there were ever a story in Ocala or Gainesville or anywhere in north central Florida, I would often be dispatched to cover it. So even as a journalist, I was familiar.
That was one of my goals in life when I was at the Times. I wanted to come up here and be the – there's a guy named Al Burt a long time ago with Miami Herald.
Yes.
Who got shot up, unfortunately, down in Haiti or something. And he came up in semi-retirement, although he worked, and he covered this whole area, Cross Creek, Gainesville, you know, Ocala. Anytime there's a story up here, anywhere in North Florida, he covered it. I said, that's a job I want to have one day, just come up here and write about things in Florida. And later on, Pete Gallagher on my staff at the St. Pete Times did, in fact, develop that beat where he wrote stuff, all kinds of folksy tales all over the state of Florida, and did some great stuff. They do some of it now. They have Craig, help me with the last name.
Craig Pittman,
who's been on this show. He does quite a few stories about North Florida, all parts of Florida, actually. So it's a fun thing to do. Times have changed. When you were at the St. Pete Times, and when I was at St. Pete Times years before that, it was a fun, thriving place to be. A lot of resources, great benefits program, too, they had, and a lot of aspiring journalists. I don't know how else to say it, but kind of a kick-ass paper. You know, it's what it was.
Mm-hmm.
And still, to this day, although I worked in New York and Denver, whatever, it's still the best paper I ever worked for because of their high ideals, their principles, of being unbending about any kind of ethics and terms and things like that. But now it's different. We all know what happened to newspapers, obviously. Some have survived. I read the other day about thousands of jobs in journalism now are gone away. You're challenged, obviously, to do as good or better job with fewer people than, say, you had in Citrus County. How many did you have in Citrus County, by the way? About eight?
I had five full-time reporters.
And you had stringers and correspondents, too, right?
Correct.
Yeah. So on the street here, and you had no production to worry about over there, too, right?
Correct.
So here you have how many people do you have on your staff?
Well, we have seven full-time reporters.
Okay, so you only got two more than you had in Citrus County, and you have stringers and stuff. So your challenge, I think probably
counting staff, how many do you have at the Star Banner, everybody together?
Well, it's tough because, as you know, we do production in Gainesville.
Right.
So the people who work in Gainesville are working for both
products. But here in Ocala, how many do you have?
Here in Ocala, probably about 20 in the newsroom.
20, okay. And that's not including Brad Rogers, who's really not in the newsroom, but writes on the editorials and things of that nature.
Correct.
Okay. So you're tasked with covering the area, and when you get down to the basic beats, which are obviously schools and cops and so on and so forth, not a lot of room there for wiggle room. How do you meet that challenge, and how do you plan to deal with that issue of resources?
Well, like any business or any endeavor, first of all, you find out your main goal, which is for us, of course, is to provide news and information about Ocala and Marion County. Then you take a look and see where are we most likely to find the high-impact news. Obviously, you have obligations to cover government and schools and law enforcement and the courts and things like that. So we emphasize those areas heavily. We always have it's traditional old-school newspapering, and that's what our audience expects from us. We're the watchdog, and we also let people know what's going on. Beyond that, we pick our spots. We go to Dunellen from time to time when there's a big story brewing. We've put a big emphasis on South County, particularly Bellevue, because we have readers down there and there's a lot going on. There's a lot going on in Dunellen as well, but we have to pick our spots. And then some of those stories you were talking about, buddy, about like the St. Pete Times does, we try to do some of those stories too, to find those human interest stories, those trend stories, things that tell people about the community that they live in. And often these are things that are hiding in plain sight. Mm-hmm. A lot of those stories Albert wrote and Jeff Klinkenberg and Craig Pittman for the Times, they're right there in front of you, but you just don't see them sometimes.
Sure. Yeah, that's true. And of all the beats, I know that if you call them that anymore, because really people have to cover different things. When Dave Slinker, obviously, he does the arts and things of that nature, does that well. And then you've got Bill Thompson, who does county government, and My question to you is, do you find the enterprising reporters as much as let's say, you used to? A lot of times, I'd say even most of the time, the reporters would come to you with a story and say, I've got an idea, I would like to pursue this story. And it's that gut instinct that these reporters have, that something is there when you don't see it as an editor. Do you have a lot of that, or is that just sort of 50-50? Is it give and take? How do you decide what to assign your reporters?
It's a bit of both, but what I like to say is that reporters play offense and editors play defense. Mm. They come, they're on the beat, they see what's going on, they come to you with the story, and then I sit down with them and the other editors and say, okay, how do we make this into a story? How do we report it? How do we get it into the paper? But I want that aggressiveness and energy from the reporters. Not that I'm not aggressive and full of energy as well, but just channeling it a different way, just like an offense and a defense. And so we still see that a lot. The reporters at the Star Banner and all the reporters that I know at the Gainesville Sun and the other papers, everybody still has that passion. There's just fewer of us, as you were alluding to, so we have to pick our spots.
You know, the perception of the public, you probably know what I'm going to say, is that newspapers never get it right. It's not just the Star Banner. It's every newspaper. I said to you, everywhere I've lived, the worst paper in America was where they lived.
Right.
You know, it's always the kick around their local fish wrapper and all that stuff. The Star Blender, and you name it. It's true of the New York Daily News, Denver Post, even the St. Pete Times, some people... Less to say about the St. Pete Times. But so the perception is that we as journalists, and I include myself in that group, having served in that capacity for about 40 years, is that we don't get it right. Now, it's extremely difficult to get drilled down on stories because so many people lie to you, and they spin it. And all you can do is quote them, and you're perpetuating a lie by doing it, yet that's all you have to go on. So... we like to call it today's version of the truth, because the truth seems to shift based on the fact that sometimes our sources don't get it right, or sometimes we get misled. How do you go about ferreting out today's version of the truth?
Well, that's a really good question, buddy. It's age old, but it has a new version of it now with technology and the way society has gone. My number one goal, obviously, we want to get it right. We want to be accurate. We want to be balanced. But if I had to pick one thing, I'd say I want to be fair. Is what we're publishing fair? Have we gotten both sides? Have we looked at the issue? Is it something we should be writing about? And have we done the best job we can to figure out? You know, we don't call the Flat Earth Society for comment. We go to the sources that have the information. and we're fair about it. And that's my overarching goal. And you're right, it is difficult. It always has been. But it's even more difficult now because the speed of the game is a lot faster, email and social media and everything else. But by the same token, that makes it exciting as well. We have tougher challenges, but also better opportunities.
I try to tell my friends, like Tom and others, I explain one thing to them that I failed to get across to most people. As you know, and having worked for the St. Pete Times, they have a liberal policy in their editorial pages. In my nearly 4.5 years at the St. Pete Times as both sports editor and feature editor, I never had anybody ever ask me to slant a story in any way.
Me neither.
And I'm a moderate. I'm a political moderate, you know. And there's this perception that the reporters are out there and they're told to write things from a political viewpoint. How wrong is that?
I'm 25 years in the business. It's never happened to me. I've never said it to anybody. I've never heard anybody say it. Maybe they're out there, but if they are, it's Bigfoot. I haven't seen them.
And yet, that perception will probably never be changed because there's a difference in, let's say, and I'm not picking on the conservatives here at all because let's say I'm a political moderate, as my cousin calls me, a raging moderate. Is that the perception is like we're like Fox News, you know, and we just slant it politically. Now, here's Fox News. Fox News has a political agenda. That's what I tell people about talking about Fox. Yes, they can report news. They can get stories that are good, but they come at it from perspective of a political agenda. That's the difference in a really, really great newspaper and a network. You're not trying to slant it one way or the other. You might be more sensitive to some issues, just to be honest about that. I mean, if there's a migrant camp story, yeah, New York Times is probably going to run it. Let's be honest about that. The fact remains is, though, that to say that a newspaper's editorial policy sets also the political philosophy of the paper, guides the city editor and the reporters and what they report, it's just not factual.
It's not been my experience at all. And I think what critics would say is that they look at a story and say, well, here's what you didn't include. It's not that what you have there is wrong, but you didn't include this voice, or you privileged this particular voice over that particular voice. And sometimes those criticisms are fair, and you can deconstruct a story like that. But you're talking about intent and approach, and I just don't see it.
I got you. Jim Ross, the new managing editor of the Star Banner. Tom McNiff now, your predecessor, is in Leesburg, I understand.
That's right. He's the executive editor.
Of the Leesburg, is it Commercial?
The Daily Commercial.
Okay. And that's formerly a member, that was formerly a, I'm getting texts from our friend, Tom, as you might guess.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah. About giving me the lowdown his thoughts about the spinning stories. Leesburg Commercial used to be part of the chain when the New York Times owns. I remember that.
That's right.
And now that is part of the Halifax Group?
It is now.
Okay.
We bought it three months ago.
Why don't you explain the Halifax Group and who they are? In a time when people are ditching newspapers, except for Warren Buffett, apparently, and the guy who owns Amazon.com, Halifax has been buying and expanding. Tell us about Halifax out of Daytona and what they're about.
Well, there's a gentleman named Michael Redding who used to work for the Daytona paper, and then he went on and was into some other business ventures involving newspapers, and he came back and bought the Daytona paper, which, as you might remember, was in a bit of an ownership struggle with
Davison family.
The family background. He bought that paper, and there's a group of investors who work with him, and together they're called Halifax Media. And then back a couple years ago, they decided to buy the regional group from the New York Times Company, which included the Star Banner, Gainesville Sun, Sarasota, Lakeland, I think 16 papers in all. So the company kind of overnight went from 1 to 17 or 18. And since then, Halifax has acquired several more papers in Florida and the Southeast, including Leesburg, which is the most recent acquisition. And they've been very good to us. They've been very good to Ocala. You mentioned before about, you know, influence on news coverage. Nothing like that at all. We continue to do what we think is right in Ocala, and that is supported. And they've been very good owners to us and good to Ocala.
All right, now you moved up to managing editor. Who took the job as city editor, or do you have one?
Well, our ownership, our leadership structure is kind of shifting right now.
Okay.
Susan Smiley-Height, in fact, just today, was promoted to local news editor.
Okay.
She had been the assistant city editor. She's kind of my partner in crime. We sit side by side and help run the city desk. Mm-hmm. So there's me and Susan. Richard Aguiano is our business editor. You mentioned Dave Schlenker earlier as our entertainment editor. And then we get support from Gainesville as well. So it's kind of a cast of thousands, as you like to say, with the editing. And it's a good group of people, good journalists.
I want to give a shout-out to somebody. I did this last time you were on, I believe. A guy who's not a full-time person who seems to be at the right place, right time. Carlos Medina. He seems to get stories that other people don't get. He seems to hit on the subjects. Some people have that knack of knowing what's a story and why it's important. I don't know Carlos. I've never met him, but I am really impressed with his nose for news and knowing how to what is a story and how to get a story.
Carlos is a good guy. He's one of our trusted correspondents, and you're right. I mean, he's been around town for a long time and knows a lot, particularly about horses and the horse community. I agree with that sentiment.
All right, we come back. I want to ask you about specifically some big stories that you're covering, naturally Silver Springs being one, the sheriff being another, which is the news lately, and get your, you don't have to give me editorial comments, but just enlighten us about these stories, if they have quote-unquote legs, you know, what your staff will be looking into, and how you're trying to hopefully help us all have a better community by, you know, giving us all the truth we can possibly get, you know. So Jim Ross, the new managing editor of the Star Banner, is our guest. We are live at the Gateway Bank on a Friday. It's Community Gazette Day and actually Star Banner Day, too, because Jim's here. So stay tuned for more to come right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
You know, Austin, I'm sitting here at the computer looking at our Facebook page, and boy, we really need to tell more listeners about our Facebook page.
No, Tom, see, you got it all wrong. Twitter is the new age.
What's a tweeter?
No, a Twitter, Tom. The Voice of Ocala has a Twitter.
We do? Well, how do we tell our listeners about that?
All they have to do is get the Twitter app or go to twitter.com, type in Voice of Ocala in the search box, and click follow.
All right, well, what's a tweeter do?
The Voice of Ocala's Twitter page updates all of its followers on the latest news, guests, giveaways, and contests.
Oh, okay. But couldn't listeners just tune in weekdays from 3 to 6 to 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, or even go to online at WOCA.com? Wouldn't that be easier?
Yeah, okay, maybe.
You know what that anticipation feels like when you're about to open a gift? In a Box offers personalized gifts. Everything you'll need for that special occasion. In a Box. Holidays, birthdays, graduations, spa days, weddings, anniversaries, get wells, and more. In a Box. Visit InABoxCelebrations.com and pick your theme. There's even a corporate option. In a Box creates the magic, and you'll be the rock star. Visit InABoxCelebrations.com, partnered with Woodley Gardens.
Mayhem is everywhere.
I'm the football your buddy fired through your windshield. The cooler that tumbled out of a pickup and onto the hood of your car. If you're a football fan, eventually, we're going to meet. So get Allstate, where agents help keep you protected from mayhem. Like me.
Are you in good hands?
Hey, this is Kevin McDonald, your local Allstate agent. Call me at 622-2333, and let's make sure you're in good hands.
Got a trade? You're in luck. Current high market demand means you'll get more for your trade than ever before at Palm Chevrolet in Ocala. And log on to PalmChevroletSpecials.com to receive an additional $1,000 trade assistance offer. That's PalmChevroletSpecials.com for your bonus trade offer. According to the Wall Street Journal, a one-year-old Civic that NADA's used car guide valued at $14,275 a few months ago is now estimated to be worth $15,950. As mentioned earlier, your trade is worth more than ever. That's why Palm Chevrolet wants your trade and is willing to pay absolute top dollar. Remember, visit PalmChevroletSpecials.com to receive an additional $1,000 trade assistance offer. Hurry, this is a very limited time offer at Palm Chevrolet on Southwest College Road in Ocala. And go to PalmChevroletSpecials.com to get an exclusive $1,000 bonus trade assistance offer. Chevy, find new roads. Trade value may be less based on excessive mileage and vehicle wear and tear. See dealer for details.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge, undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
All right, back with Jim Ross, the Star Banner. Jim, during the break, we were talking about some of the challenges, and one of them is for the short staff is cleaning up the typos. You know, it's one thing. Listen, I know I just got a text from a guy who just said, oh, the Star Banner gets mistakes. Every newspaper has mistakes. Let me tell you. I've been through it. I've been there, done it. Every paper has it. And it's not because people aren't spending time and energy and effort to do it. You just don't have time to catch every comma because you're not manned to do that. Now, there's one paper over in St. Augustine who decided to do something about that, not part of your chain. And they decided, the editor did, well, we had complaints about all the mistakes. Let's recruit some people, have a contest, let them come in, and let them proof the paper every night. How'd that work out?
Well, I guess time will tell. But, yeah, they were going to give a free dinner, I think, to whoever found the most mistakes. So that's one way to go about it. I mean, it's a human endeavor, you know, and there's always an – when I read papers, New York Times, Wall Street Journal, you know, I pick up on things as well. And it's a human endeavor, and you're going to have human error.
They may find that works over there in St. Augustine, because at the Hawthorne Christmas Festival that I host every year, buddy, one of the ways we clean the street up at the end of the day is we get $21 bills and get all the children that are left, give them a garbage bag, say the kid with the most garbage in his bag gets a dollar, and they all run around and we give them all a dollar, but they clean the street up.
I guess that's a violation of labor laws, I think.
but they clean the street up.
Yeah, I know. Well, it is getting the community involved, I'll say that,
yeah.
Which is really what you want.
Yes.
You want your community to be involved in your publication, your show, radio show, which we try to do here, involve people. This is really your show, like it's your newspaper. And the more you can get input, the better. Now, back in the days, there were some pretty arrogant newsrooms, you know, and I've heard people slam, hang up on callers and, you know, be rude, whatever. One of the things that our publisher down in, an owner down in Charlotte County used to say was, if you get something wrong, first thing you do is apologize.
Yes.
90% of the people who get angry over want to sue, and that rarely happens, but who want to threaten, if you apologize and try to make amends in some fashion, it's over. It's the people who get arrogant about it and refuse to say, well, that's too bad, pal. That's the breaks, you know. They get mad, they want retribution. So that's a very important part of the equation. What's your policy on things, on corrections?
Well, our corrections run on page 1B. And if something is wrong in a story, we correct it. We go online and correct it right away. And then in the next day's paper, we put a correction on page 1B. And people, if they bring it to our attention, then we do it. Mm-hmm. If we find out ourselves, if we're reading a story and find out we made an error, we correct it. I'm not, I mean, I'd love to make no errors, but that's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. So I'm fine with that. And that's the old St. Pete Times policy as well. I mean, you know, buddy. That was they would put corrections on the front page of the paper. And that's just, I think people look at that, they might look at it and say, you don't know what you're doing, look at all these corrections. Or they might look at it and say, it's a human endeavor, and at least you're owning up to the mistakes and trying to make it right.
And furthermore, I think each person who works on the paper has to be held to the same standard as the people you report. And a great example of that, the late Gene Patterson, who was the editor of the St. Pete Times, got a DUI. Now, here's the thing. In those days, no local stories were allowed on the front page. It was all wire. We never put a story on the front page. Patterson got arrested, hauled in, got a DUI. He made them put the story on the front page.
That's right.
And that's, you know, that to me is people, that should restore the confidence of people think there's some game going on here with, you know, playing favorites. Because it doesn't matter if it's you or your kid or your relative or your next door neighbor. You can't leave those things out. You just can't do it. Let's talk about a couple of stories. In your mind, what are the two or three working stories right now that your people are reporting about that are paramount in the minds of the public?
Well, the Yankees deal is still with us. I guess April is the big deadline that we're looking to. And I guess we'll see if the county and the city leaders and the other business leaders can make something happen between now and then. But I'm still excited about that. I think it's a good story. It's got legs, as you say. And I think it says something not just in and of itself, although that's important enough, but it also says something about us as a community. How do we want to do this when we get an offer like this and an opportunity like this? How do we want to handle it? And I think we're learning a lot about our elected leaders and our business community, and you read the letters to the editor. I think you learn a lot. I don't know how it's going to work out, but I've learned some lessons.
Mistakes were made, obviously, and in my mind continue to be made. But what was the flaw in the way this thing came down? If you see that there were flaw, if your reporters are following the story, what do you see as the issue here, as to how the story got told or didn't get told, how the non-disclosure deal kept them from coming forward and presenting the issue to the public? They hope to get it on the ballot and then explain it. Was it because anything to do involved in raising taxes, no matter what it is, they're going to vote it down? What was the issue here, and what's the storyline today on that particular aspect of it?
Well, I think you touched on it. I think it's a lot to do with that referendum and the speed, how quickly it was coming up with the March date. And even though people with the city had been dealing with this for quite some time, the rest of us hadn't, including, most importantly, the county. And I think some people felt a little stung by that. And I don't know if there was a way around it or not, but I think that was definitely an issue. I don't think there was a problem with communication, necessarily. I think once the information got out, it got out to the right people, and I think people understood it to the extent that it needed to be understood. I just think at the county level, I think they're very wary of putting that tax referendum out there, and that's the system we have. And I understand it, and I respect it. I know you do, too.
I do. I will say two things quick on this story, and I'll move to another story, is that one of them is I feel confident it's going to serve us again in a different package. Mm-hmm. The 1 cent sales tax, which I believe Brad Rogers supported originally, and others have talked about it, that would encompass other needs, including, even some of the school issues. Although the sales tax is tricky because it can't be used for salaries, and then of course the sheriff has needs, obviously, public safety, what have you. Those are things, and even Silver Springs, to a certain degree, may need help from a local standpoint. Then you add the ballpark in, and you add a municipal ballpark in from the standpoint of multi-use. So it can be used for a lot of, and even could be used as maybe put a convention center in there within the complex. Mm-hmm. We badly need a convention center.
Yes.
We really need to have one. At least an all-purpose hall that could be used for all that. So those are things I think will be discussed. What I'm hearing from my sources is this is forthcoming in the next couple of months. We'll see. Another commissioner told me, kind of semi-off the record, I won't quote this person, is that when this person told three groups, two of them were Republican groups, one was another one, that the Yankees deal was pretty much dead, they were all glad. They were glad the Yankees were going to be out of the deal, which, by the way, they may not be. But this person said, oh, they were thrilled to know the Yankees were out. I guess this is that New York City boys coming down here trying to do some pull wool over our eyes. I never know. So, all right, so one more thing, and I'm going to full disclosure here that Chris Blair does a show here with Greg Graham on Fridays. He and Greg are in every other Friday. We talk about a lot of issues. We never talk about his political battles or although I asked him if there's something in the news. He was in the news yesterday again, Chris Blair. A story about Bill Thompson. I'm going to just tell you that he's a friend of the show's, so I come into a different perspective on this thing, not accusing anybody of any wrongdoing. My top-of-mind thought was, when I read the story, what I saw in the first paragraph, without really reading down, was there was a $100 dealer talking about busting his chop saw. Now, I get the backstory. I get there were other, quote-unquote, questionable things regarding his bank account with his brother-in-law and so on and so forth. What do you say to the people who say, come on, man, there's $100?
Well, keep in mind, there was actually two issues, and one had to do with his financial disclosure form and whether it was accurate when he filed it. And I think that's what the Ethics Commission is looking into further.
Right.
I think that's what it is. And there's a backstory there, of course, as your listeners know. You know, the referral to the Commission on Ethics was made, at the suggestion or the request.
Anonymous. There was an anonymous tip.
Well, the grand jury, when it returned its report, I believe it asked FDLE to send a referral to the Commission on Ethics. I believe that's correct.
Right, is that what it was?
And I believe that's what happened. So now it's going through a process. Mm-hmm. There is a process. We're covering that process. And wherever it goes, that's what we'll write about.
And that's fair. I'll say this, though, from the other human standpoint. If a guy ever had, having run through a gauntlet, Chris Blair's run through a gauntlet from day one. You know, and how he finally got there and had to go through another election almost to get there, and he gets there and he faces up. I mean, he has had obstacle after obstacle after obstacle after obstacle. If he comes through this and everything, I, for one, will shake his hand and say, well done, because he's really been through it. So let's hope it all works out for the best of everybody. Okay, we have a game here called Fake and Factoid. We have eight different statements where you get to say fake or factoid. Your opponents are, well, here. And probably Justin back at Austin back. Is Justin there too, by the way?
Justin is in the building.
Justin there too? Justin and Austin. Good. That's that imaginary person I have, Justin. Austin's there. We'll play Faker Factory with the new managing editor of the Star Banner, Jim Ross, after this timeout on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Allstate presents things you shouldn't have to do to find your local insurance agent. One, turn on your GPS. Two, fill up your gas tank. Three, cross state lines. That's because Allstate believes your local insurance agent should actually be local, as in located nearby. That 15-minute insurance company now claims to have local agents, but the truth is they have less than 200 spread across the entire country. Allstate has more than 12,000, so a local agent is always easy to find. They know you personally and care about you because they're members of your community too. Wherever you live, nobody protects you like an Allstate agent.
Hey, this is Kevin McDonald, and we've been local since 1985 with four locations to serve you in Ocala and the Villages. Call us today at 622-2333 or visit us online at themcdonaldagency.com and let us provide you with a comparison on all your insurance needs.
Dry, itchy, scaly skin? Do you have psoriasis? Consider joining our research study. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study evaluating the effectiveness of investigational combination of two study medications for moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. You may qualify if you're between the ages of 18 and 75 and have been diagnosed with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis for at least 6 months. For more information, please call Renstar in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Qualified participants may receive study-related medical care and study medication. Compensation for time and travel may also be provided. To find out more information about this psoriasis study, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. That's 352-629-5800, Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
On Mondays, AM Ocala Live, we'll meet a retired teacher who has become an author. Her name is Rebecca Vigis. Her new book is called Crossing the Line.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Susan Klaus will be with us. She breeds and races thoroughbred horses, raises rodeo bulls, and she's an author. Her book is called Secretariat Reborn. She's coming in to talk to us about horse cloning and the book signing event here in Ocala at HITS.
Lauren Chapin will be in the studio. She's the award-winning actress who played the character of Kitten in the 1950s hit television show Father Knows Best. She'll be performing the role of Mother Banks in the Celebration Dinner Theater production of Barefoot in the Park. Kim Lynette Sandstrom will be joining her, and they will be speaking about Barefoot in the Park.
And then it's auto repair with personal care. Matt Gibbs will answer your questions about your cars.
Greg Thompson and Melody Murphy will be in the studio with a few of the cast members from the Ocala Civic Theater's production of Do Black Patent Leather Shoes Really Reflect Up?
All of that plus Fun with Joe on Mondays, AM Ocala Live, right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Look who just walked in the room. Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security, the name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
We're back here at Gateway Bank Community Gazette Day. It's time to play that game that I'm, you know, the smartest person in the room at, buddy. Yeah,
before you do that, how about give us the Bieber report? We couldn't get.
We got to talk about this Bieber guy.
Yeah, okay. No, we don't, but we got to do it real quick.
Well, Bieber's mansion took $6,000 to clean up the marijuana smell and residue and all from
just to clean it up.
Just to clean it up. And also today, it's been reported that as he flew from Toronto, where he turned himself in for assault charges, to New Jersey, to New York City for the Super Bowl. He's going to attend the Super Bowl. Private airport, Teterboro Airport. His plane was surrounded by cops and searched for marijuana because the pilot of the private jet that he had chartered had reported that he smelled marijuana in the plane.
Guess what? I guess when you smoke marijuana, it probably makes a smell. Okay, time to play Fake or Factoid with Jim Ross, Tom Schmitz, and Austin Statman Tatman, if he's there. You guys ready to tee it up? Here we go.
I'm a Mr. Ross, nice guy. I'm going to beat the brakes off of
you. Yeah, well, you talk big. Number one, at age 12, Olympic champion Usain Bolt outran Jamaica's national sprint champion.
Fact.
Fact.
Fact. Three facts? Anybody want to change their answer?
No.
Fake.
Well, we're all...
There's three messages right there. You guys are easy. Number two, some eagles can fly faster than a commercial prop airplane.
Fact.
Yeah, that sounds fact.
I'll say factoid.
Fact, too? Three facts?
No, I'll say not.
You say fact, you say fake.
Fake. Fake.
You say fake?
Fake.
You, my friend, are correct. It is fake. And there's two guys with two misses around, including the big talker over here. Okay. All right. I'm on the edge. It's going to be tough. Number three, it is said that over a short distance, an alligator can outrun a racehorse.
Yes. Fact.
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 Score three. Correct. Three-pointer. That is, in fact, fact. Number four, cheetahs are faster than a Ferrari Enzo.
Fake.
Fake.
Fact.
It's fact. So that's
Austin's out.
Austin's out. At least 2-2. 2-2. The contest is getting tight. This is a special area for you. I know you'll want to zero in on. This is Tom. This is Tom Ingram's favorite group band right here.
Right.
One Direction song, What Makes You Beautiful, sold faster in the U.S. than the Beatles' first single.
Fact.
Fact.
Austin, you're out, but if you want to jump in, fine.
Fact.
All right, that's correct. That's a three-pointer. You guys are all correct. Still 2-2. Here come the final three questions. Number one, your brain has the ability and capacity to store over 1 million songs and lyrics.
Fact.
Fake.
Fact.
Jim, you're out, my friend. That is true. That is fact. Okay. Tom, you're the winner. Two more questions just for exhibition.
Was it ever in doubt?
I got to put up with this. I was so hoping you'd beat him. All right. As a teen, murder mystery novelist Ann Perry assisted her best friend in murdering her mother.
Fake.
Fact.
It's fact.
Wow.
Finally, the city of Tokyo was originally called Edo. Edo. Edo.
Fact.
Fact.
It's fact. Anybody want to play pick the number?
Yeah, let's do it.
The largest amount of text messages sent by a single person in 1 month was? Most text messages ever sent in 1 month was?
16,500.
20,000.
25,000. You want to jump in, Josh? 30. Yeah, if you're playing Josh to win, how about this number? 182,689.
Wow.
That's a lot of text, right? What's that plan they call? Where you unlimited text? If he didn't, brother, he got stuck with a bill. Hey, Jim Ross, always good to have you on. Hope you'll come back. Good luck to you down at Star Banner.
Thanks, buddy.
Appreciate it. Thanks for the work that you do. Coming up next hour, time to talk Super Bowl. We'll make our picks again. We'll talk about where we're going to watch the bowl game, down the Marion Theater, and what Roger Goodell says about the weather. All coming your way. Plus Joe Williams, and do we have a high school athletic spotlight today?
We do.
With Josh LaSalva coming up your way right here on Buddy Sports Page next on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source. Gotta get that boom, boom, boom. That boom, boom, boom. That boom, boom, boom.
That hit to beat the block, you can get that bass on. But like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Dry, itchy, scaly skin? Do you have psoriasis? Consider joining our research study. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study evaluating the effectiveness of investigational combination of two study medications for moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. You may qualify if you're between the ages of 18 and 75 and have been diagnosed with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis for at least 6 months. For more information, please call Renstar in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Qualified participants may receive study-related medical care and study medication. Compensation for time and travel may also be provided. To find out more information about this psoriasis study, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. That's 352-629-5800. Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
Your home for CF Patriot basketball all season long. WOCA, The Source.
AA Lock, Dock, and Security has moved to a brand new location and wants to personally invite you to the spectacular grand opening event on Friday, February 7th. Come by and see the very latest in lock and security technologies. WOCA will be there broadcasting live and giving away some station swag and some fantastic prizes from top name brands like Stanley, Honeywell, Paxton Access, Aero Medico, Master Lock, and more. Plus, we're giving away not one, but two grand prizes, a home security system fully installed and monitored for a full year, and a business access control keyless entry system fully installed. There'll be hot dogs, hamburgers, drinks, and more, so bring a friend and come help us celebrate with food, fun, and prizes for the new location grand opening of AA Lock, Dock, and Security. It's all happening Friday, February 7th, at the brand new location, 219 Northwest 10th Street, just a 10th mile east of 441. That's Friday, February 7th, AA Lock, Dock, and Security.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Just say anything as long as you say something. Got it? This is the rule when it comes to job interviews. People who drank 2 cups of green tea a day lost 3 pounds in 3 months without changing their diets. People who sleep on the left side of the bed tend to be more cheerful, better able to handle stress, and tackle heavy workloads compared to those who sleep on the right side of the bed.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Don't miss this stuff.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the Links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
ABC News Now, I'm Daria Albinger. Justin Bieber is planning to spend Super Bowl weekend in New York and New Jersey. If he will, that's another story. There are reports that drug-sniffing dogs and customs agents are searching a plane that he flew on to a private airport in New Jersey. If you are going to the Super Bowl, leave the big purse at home. You can't take anything larger than a clutch to the game, even on mass transit. It could be short showers and dirty cars for a lot of people in California. The state's cutting off the water it delivers to customers as an historic drought continues. Yahoo email users, this may be a good time to change your password. The search engine's email system is one of the latest victims of a security breach. Passwords for about 273 million accounts were taken. Fair? Hardly. But it's reality in Hollywood. An actress's asking price drops as her age increases. A new survey finds most female stars make the most money per film when they're 34, and then their earnings quickly decline. Male stars usually peak at age 51. This is ABC News.
A lot can happen during the life of your interstate car battery.
The Berlin Wall has officially come down. Stores are running out of stock as people race for Y2K. The curse is over! They win the series! And the latest craze, space tourism. Who knew?
No battery lasts longer than an interstate. And the new Interstate AGM lasts up to 3 times longer than the competition. To find a dealer near you, visit interstatebatteries.com.
Watch what happens when I need something for business. Say my laptop just died.
Office Max has laptops, tablets, and printers that are perfect for you.
How'd she know? And why is this report in black and white?
Office Max has most major brands of ink and toner at the lowest prices guaranteed.
Okay, I'll go. Right after I clean up these files.
Office Max has cloud storage, so you can be productive on the road.
Isn't she amazing?
If you need it for your business, you'll find it at Office Max, all at great prices. Restrictions apply. See store officemax.com.
I'm a shot. 30. 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho. Ho, ho, ho.
And now it's time for the Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
Like I don't fit in. Like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poor house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
Here's Buddy.
Our Know He's Speaking this would be Chris Spears, Spot Chris is out of no doubt selling cars out of Prestige. And of course, there's a reason he continues to sell so many to people in Ocala and Marion County, because number one, he finds good cars. He doesn't want to keep those cars, likes to sell them. And so he puts a good price on them, and he's able to provide financing around the spot right there without having to go through all the hassle. Chris likes to say he buys a lot of nice cars, he just doesn't want to keep them. So if you need an automobile and you don't want to buy a brand new, go by and see Chris Spears either at the location in Bellevue or out on Highway 200 College Road, and ask him to, if you don't see it on the lot, what you want, ask him to see if he can find one for you. Or maybe you got a car you'd like to sell. He told a story last week about a person he sold a car to 12 years ago who came back and resold him the car 12 years later. So there's a reason people like doing business with Chris Spears, because he looks out for your interest. He's a local guy, community guy, and somebody who takes great joy and pleasure out of fixing you up with a car, especially sometimes the hard to finance ones. Check him out. Prestige Auto, Chris Spears. Again, two locations to serve you, Bellevue and Highway 200 College Road. Prestige4U.com. You can see the cars there. All right, time now to deal with the subject at hand, which is the Super Bowl. Why don't you go get our friend there and tell him to come on in and let him give his picks. We've all made our picks. I'm sticking with by mine, by the way. I'm still saying Broncos win by a point.
And you don't look like you're going to sway from that.
I'm not, because I think I like the bet of taking 2.5 or 3 in Seattle. But I don't want the Broncos to lose the game. So I can't pick against them. So I'll take Seattle in the points, but I'm cheering for the Broncos. I think they win the game.
And I think Seattle outduels the Broncos, but it's all going to depend on whether the Seahawks create happy feet with Peyton Manning. They can create happy feet by getting pressure on him from the front four. It'll be a long afternoon for the Broncos. If Peyton Manning can stand back there and have four and a half seconds to throw the football,
well,
they'll win by more than 1 point.
Nobody gets 4 seconds to go and throw it. That's too many. I heard somebody say today that 1.7 is the time it takes the defensive lineman to get to you. So if you're holding it 4 seconds, you got problems. But you know, it's interesting what's going to happen. Probably somebody's name we haven't mentioned all week long will be the one who makes the big play. We've talked about the quarterbacks, Russell Wilson, Peyton Manning. We talked about Richard Sherman. We talked about who else we discussed? Marshawn Lynch. And on.
And no Sean Moreno's name hasn't come up at all.
I did one time. I brought it up yesterday saying that I don't know if it's bad weather, whether it's going to be favorable to no Sean Moreno, because he's not the grinder that Marshawn Lynch is. But the weather apparently is not going to be that bad. High of 49, low of 26, and no precipitation expected. And so if there was a weather game, I would go with Seattle. But I think it would impact Peyton's throwing, and I think Marshawn Lynch is the better running back. But it's not a weather game. I'm going to go with the Broncos. I'm going with the Broncos anyway. However, that's just me. Let's find out some other picks, like the CEO and chairman of Gateway Bank, who is good at numbers. In fact, didn't he go undefeated 1 week, or is that Albert Peake?
Albert Peake.
Okay, but he won the contest 1 week.
Yes.
He fancies himself as an oracle, Tom Ingram.
Great to be here. Who's playing again? of course you're going to pick Denver. I mean,
well,
you work for the Denver Post. You're a homer.
Yeah.
So
I admit it.
Yeah, okay.
I'm a homer.
Okay, I think it's important.
I like
important.
Pat Bowlen. I like John Elway. I like Peyton Manning. I like the story. I root for the stories too. You know.
Yeah. Well, who doesn't like Peyton Manning? I mean. Yeah, we beat him, what, four, how many times? 3 or 4 times?
Well, he never beat Florida.
He never beat us.
Yeah.
At Florida, so you got to love that. But, no, seriously, he's a class act, and, yeah, you just like to see a guy like that continue to be successful. And I saw a couple of his clips from his press conference, and he just has a way about him that I think people love, and certainly from the popularity standpoint, a lot of people are going to be rooting for Denver just because of him. And I hope he does well, has a record game, and wins the Super Bowl, wins the second Super Bowl. I think it'll be exciting and amazing. And I'm just looking forward to the game because you get two top seeds, which doesn't happen very often.
Very rarely.
Yeah. And that's going to be fun to watch. And hopefully it'll live up to the billing there. And yeah, I think people are anticipating a very close game, similar to what the Auburn-FSU game was for the national
championship. Let me ask you this, Tom, because you don't cover football the way we cover football, the way we look at it on a daily basis and talk about it. You're the average fan, good football fan.
Yep.
Do you think there's been a lot of talk about Peyton Manning and his legacy? Do you think he has to win this football game to secure his legacy in the NFL?
No, not at all. I mean, he'll go down as one of the greats. Regardless, and you know, look at Dan Marino. I mean, Dan Marino never won a Super Bowl. Peyton's got one under his belt, and he will be greater if he wins, of course. But he'll still go down as one of the game's all-time greats.
Here's the difference: He wins this game, he moves up to the top three of the elite.
He becomes elite.
If he doesn't, he probably stays top five. Yeah. You can make a case for him to be in the way he plays the position. The cerebral aspect of it, how he's able to guess a coach on the field in uniform almost. You can make a case for him being as good as they're played. However, his mechanics aren't that good in terms he doesn't throw a beautiful ball. Even he said this week, when Richard Sherman said he throws ducks, and he said, yeah, I throw ducks. I was proud to throw all those ducks for yardage and touchdown and whatever it may be.
I love that.
Yeah, it was funny. But, I mean, if he wins this game, it's another level.
Absolutely.
And now you won't have any questions. When you mentioned the great quarterbacks, he'll have to be top three probably. If he doesn't, he won't be top three. On his record alone, I mean, I hate to say it. I mean, Dan Marino is a heck of a quarterback, but he's 0-1, and he'll never be ranked as the best ever or the top three, in my opinion, because of it.
But I agree.
There are people that are literally – I've heard – No less, and I took notes. I would say their names. I mean, I could say their names. Newey Scruggs on NBC Sports, Merrill Hodge on ESPN. There's Chris Mannix of ESI. There's been numerous people that have said he has to win this football game or his legacy will be he can't win the big one. And I don't understand that because he's already won the big one.
Right.
but somebody else, who was it yesterday that said they thought that, buddy? We had somebody on the radio that said.
Probably Bianchi.
It was Bianchi that said.
Bianchi says a lot of things. So,
but I understand. But Bianchi said, Mike Bianchi, the Orlando Sentinel columnist, said that Peyton has to win this game to, you know, show that he can, because he'll be thought of as a guy that can't win the big one. But he's already won a Super Bowl. How is that possible?
How many has he lost? How many Super Bowls?
Peyton?
Yeah.
He's lost one, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's 1-1.
Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, he's 1-1. He went. I agree.
Eli, by the way, is 1-2.
Right.
He'll never be an elite quarterback, but he's 1-2.
Yeah.
He'll never be a top five.
Will he be a Hall of Famer?
Probably, yeah. He'll be a Hall of Famer, but he won't be a top five of all time.
No, right now, do you not think, when you think about the game of football right now, do you not think about Johnny Unitas, Joe Montana, Bradshaw, and then Brady and Manning are the next names out of your mouth.
And you haven't even mentioned, by the way, Otto Graham, won about seven titles.
Well,
you know,
you have to be a little older to remember that.
But I mean,
you have to read. That's all reading.
But I mean, isn't he already in the conversation with Johnny Unitas, Joe Montana, and Terry Bradshaw, Peyton Manning, and Tom Brady?
Oh yeah, he was
already in that conversation.
Brady and Manning right now, I mean, he's my good friend. And, I worked with him for years. He'll be ahead of Bradshaw, in my opinion.
And Bradshaw had four wins.
And he benefited from a great defense.
Yes.
He had just as many picks as he did touchdown passes, by the way. Great player and all that kind of stuff. And I wouldn't take anything from him. But when you start talking, I'm talking about you project careers based on the fact you expect Manning to play two more years and you expect Brady to play two, three more years. When they get done, they're going to both be in the top five, for sure.
Yeah. How do you compare Manning with Elway?
That's a tough one because I saw John play a lot of football for years and followed him very closely. I think right now I give the edge to Elway because he's such a gamer. He played with his legs and his arms both. He made a lot of big third downs on just scrambling for yardage himself. He willed his team to win. The reason he lost those Super Bowls is that they weren't that good. He got them there anyway. and he lost two Super Bowls. And then, of course, he won.
Right.
So I think right now I got to go with Elway just a hair above him. But
if Peyton wins,
he wins. He goes above.
Yeah, I agree.
Let me remind.
Ironically, and it was Elway who got Manning there. Yeah,
let me remind both of you of this fact. Peyton Manning this year set the NFL passing record for a single season, set the NFL touchdown record for a season, and he's had four neck surgeries. Okay? There are people that after four neck surgeries would be on permanent disability getting a check from the government, and instead Peyton Manning's out getting 320-pound gorillas chasing him around.
That's not even the most impressive stat. He's got, what, four or five receivers with 10 touchdowns?
Right, exactly.
That'll never be broken.
No, the stat is
anybody.
That stat is that he's doing all this, and he's had four neck surgeries.
Well, I think the other thing, how many times has he been on Saturday Night Live? That's got to be in there somewhere.
He's a funny guy. He's a funny guy.
I mean, he gets a lot of credit there. Right.
Now, we're way over time because the two Toms have been talking way too
much. Because we were
much.
So good. You just
You're
kept
so good.
Going, right?
I got to read this whole thing before we go, and then we'll take a break. Come back and try to get reorganized around here. Rick Riley. You guys know Rick Riley.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Riley wrote this about Elway. This is, I thought, really, really good stuff. If his Denver Broncos beat the Seattle Seahawks this Sunday in Super Bowl 49, Elway would do something no one has ever done. He'd be the first Super Bowl MVP to win a Super Bowl as the executive in charge. He won two with his arms and legs, and now he can win one with his brain. Quote, I always wanted to be good at something other than football, he says. Even when I was young, I wanted to show I had a mind, too. Pretty good stuff right there. Huh?
Yeah,
remember, Stanford graduate, so pretty sure.
Yeah.
Tom, have a good weekend. Thanks
Same
for
here. Look forward
hosting
to the
us.
Super
Bowl. Appreciate you hosting. Come on the show, and all the best. We'll talk to you soon.
All right. Go Broncos.
Tom Ingram. He's a Bronco fan. We'll return with Josh DeSalva, Joe Williams. Much more to come on the program. Call Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
Are you looking for a trustworthy auto care company that won't sell you something you don't need? Look no further than Affordable Auto Air and Care. Affordable Auto Air and Care has serviced Ocala for a decade and is family owned and operated. They offer quality parts at affordable prices, and they even include a 1 year or 12,000 mile warranty on their parts and labor. Their certified technicians work on any type of vehicle, even RVs. They specialize in auto AC, but they also offer oil changes, brake service, filters, tune-ups, shocks, axles, complete auto repair. Affordable Auto Air and Care is located at 1841 Northwest 4th Avenue on the corner of Old Jacksonville Road and 441. Call 352-401-0011 to book an appointment. That's 352-401-0011. Affordable Auto Air and Care. Complete auto repair. Take it from me, Tom Schmitz. I'm a customer.
We're not just the horse capital of the world. Ocala Marion County is now the hoops capital, too, thanks to the 2013 national champion CF Patriots basketball team. The McDonald Allstate Agency brings you the reigning kings of the court all season long right here on WOCA. Coach Tim Ryan and the Patriots look to defend their national crown and get set to host the state tournament this coming spring. The McDonald Allstate Agency brings you CF basketball only on WOCA, The Source.
On Mondays, AM Ocala Live, we'll meet a retired teacher who has become an author. Her name is Rebecca Vigis. Her new book is called Crossing the Line.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Susan Klaus will be with us. She breeds and races thoroughbred horses, raises rodeo bulls, and she's an author. Her book is called Secretariat Reborn. She's coming in to talk to us about horse cloning and a book signing event here in Ocala at HITS.
Lauren Chapin will be in the studio. She's the award-winning actress who played the character of Kitten in the 1950s hit television show Father Knows Best. She'll be performing the role of Mother Banks in the Celebration Dinner Theater production of Barefoot in the Park. Kim Lynette Sandstrom will be joining her, and they will be speaking about Barefoot in the Park.
And then it's auto repair with personal care. Matt Gibbs will answer your questions about your cars.
Greg Thompson and Melody Murphy will be in the studio with a few of the cast members from the Ocala Civic Theater's production of Do Black Patent Leather Shoes Really Reflect Up?
All of that plus Fun with Joe on Mondays, AM Ocala Live, right here on the Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you. Called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
1370 WOCA.
Back on Buddy Sports Page, coming up in just a moment, Josh DeSalvas at High School Athletic Spotlight. But first, a little basketball talk. Gators won last night. Basketball team, another one, a tough outing at Starkville. Good second half rally, got them going. But it took Patrick Young didn't play well. Scotty Wilbekin didn't play well. Casey Prather played not up to his standards. Did score 16 points. But they got the win and got out of there. So it was their 12th straight victory, and they're 18-2 and 7-0. They play Texas A&M tomorrow at the O-Dome. Speaking of basketball, a loss for the CF Patriots, something we don't talk about very much on this program, but on Wednesday night, Tom James was on the call, and the Patriots got beat in overtime. And after the game, Tom James hooked up with Coach Tim Ryan. Here's what he said.
You know, I think tonight was all about decision making, and the first decision that we made was not to get up for this game, not to come hard for this game, and it started this morning and continued through the day. And you can tell from the very first play we had a three point play, got a steal, and we lacked today to go put a behind the back pass with three guys on us instead of finishing it off. And that was just an indicator of the rest of the night to come.
All right, that was Tom James with Coach Tim Ryan, who was not a happy camper. I think it's safe to say the Patriots will be worked out pretty hard on this practice.
Well, if you heard it live, like I heard it, or Austin was sitting right there, buddy.
Mm-hmm.
He was vehement in his demeanor and his manner and his tone that he knew this game was lost from that morning. That he knew his players weren't taking it serious. That they were flat, and that they were doing nothing to get game ready. Isn't that what you took from that, Austin?
Yeah, definitely. And like you mentioned, vehement. Coach Ryan's not one of those guys you're going to see jumping up and down, making a big scene on the sidelines. He basically did everything he could to control himself after the game and be as calm and as correct as possible. But you could tell he was definitely frustrated with the way the day had gone and the game had gone.
Well, because they played Florida State College at Jacksonville, a team that came into the game 10-9 on the season, 0-2 in the district, and they were not supposed to even be close to. Of course, you're a national champion, defending national champion. You're going to get every team's best game. But I got the feeling Coach Ryan thought Jacksonville's best game still shouldn't have beat his Patriots at all.
Oh, no, definitely not. And CF had beaten the two games that before that game, CF had beaten the two teams that Florida State College Jacksonville had lost to significantly. So
Daytona and Santa Fe.
Yes, correct. And CF didn't struggle with them at all. So CF should have won that game, especially on their home floor, handily.
All right. Coming up next, Josh DeSalvo, special guest at High School Athletic Spotlight. Joe Williams will be along after the break after that. And then we'll talk a little bit about the Tom, one of your favorite things is the commercials.
I'm having a good time with them already.
And, you know, every year they have, like, Budweiser has great ones. I mean,
if you haven't seen the Budweiser one yet, mm-hmm. with the puppy and the horse.
I hear that's all Ooh. Online talking. How people saying,
it's a tornado of adorable, people are calling it.
It'll get you.
Yeah.
Well, we'll check. And then there's Danica Patrick blown all up like Arnold Schwarzenegger. So they're going to be funny.
Sounds like somebody's been watching Super Bowl commercials.
I have.
Yeah. We'll take that break. We'll come back next right here on the Buddy Sports Page with Josh DeSalvo on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
You know, Austin, I'm sitting here at the computer looking at our Facebook page, and boy, we really need to tell more listeners about our Facebook page.
No, Tom, see, you got it all wrong. Twitter is the new age.
What's a tweeter?
No, a Twitter, Tom. The Voice of Ocala has a Twitter.
We do? Well, how do we tell our listeners about that?
All they have to do is get the Twitter app or go to twitter.com, type in Voice of Ocala in the search box, and click follow.
All right, well, what's the tweeter do?
The Voice of Ocala's Twitter page updates all of its followers on the latest news, guests, giveaways, and contests.
Oh, okay. But couldn't listeners just tune in weekdays from 3 to 6 to 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, or even go to online at WOCA.com? Wouldn't that be easier?
Yeah, okay, maybe.
Whenever something big happens in Ocala and Marion County, Buddy Martin is there on the case.
Head coach of the Florida Gator basketball team, Coach Billy Donovan. How are you feeling right now about this team in 2013-2014?
You know, Buddy, I like these kids a lot. They've worked very hard. It's a good group. The most challenging part for me has been a coach has been the inconsistency of players in practice.
So remember, always check out Buddy Martin on the Voice of Ocala on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
If you didn't catch a round the water cooler on Buddy's sports page this week, here's what you missed.
During the season, I really don't say much. You know, the week of the game, you say something nice about your opponent. Just, you know, you don't talk trash during the season. But in the off season, the summertime, some people like to hear something a little cute or funny. So I think it's fair for all of us coaches in the off season to give our fans a little something to get a smile on their face about.
Around the Water Cooler, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 5 o'clock on Buddy's Sports Page.
Okay, guys, listen up. It's that time of year again. Little chocolate hearts, roses, earrings. Valentine's Day's coming up. Last year, you got me slippers that didn't fit. The year before, it was a steering wheel cover for my car. And don't even get me started on the vacuum cleaner incident. Now, don't get me wrong, flowers and jewelry would be nice, but this year, I'd like something I can thank you for every single day. That new bathroom I've been dreaming about. You know, the one with the rain heads, body sprayers, touchless faucets, bidet, and even the seat warmer. So here's what you do. Step one, return the crock pot and apron that you thought were good ideas. Step two, pick up the phone and call Mike Scott Plumbing now.
You heard the lady, guys. Call today to schedule an appointment to visit one of our beautiful showrooms, the main showroom in Hernando or the new showroom in Wildwood right across from Brownwood Square. Call today, 237-2888. That's 237-2888. And remember, if water runs through it, we do it. Mike Scott Plumbing.
And that leaf blower in the closet better be for your mother.
Hey, Lance.
Yes, George.
Your cousin Myrtle wants to watch TV.
So?
She wants to watch TV in our living room.
So?
Well, she needs your chair.
Go get her chair.
But it's in Devon Self Storage, and she wrapped it well with the supplies, and it's 8 o'clock at night.
So? Devon Self Storage is open late, and you have your passcode, and you know where they are across from Hobby Lobby.
But, hey, Lance.
You can call them tomorrow at 873-0777 and thank them for being open late.
But, Alice, I just got my warm jammies.
George.
I'll be back with a chair from Devon Self Storage.
Thanks, George. Thanks.
Howdy, RL here to tell you about a great deal at Dairy Queen. For only $4.49, you can warm up to a hot, juicy combo of either a foot-long, quarter-pound all-beef chili dog or a tasty home-style cheeseburger, smoking hot off the char grill. Both get fries and a drink. You can add a sundae for only 99 cents. Now that's a doggone good deal at Dairy Queen, Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information-hungry, better-educated, high-income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
We are back on Community Gazette Day live from Gateway Bank. Buddy Sports Page, time now to go to the, well, it's probably not as popular as I give it credit for because Josh LaSalva is just not a popular guy, but here's the athletic high school athletic spotlight with Josh LaSalva.
I might not be popular, but I know my guests are.
That's all you gotta have. You gotta. Hey,
so that's
what Buddy and I do. Mediocre host, great guest.
Hey, that's all what radio is about, is it not? So today on the show, our phenomenal guest, Knox Strawbridge, the Forest High School head soccer coach, second year of coaching under his belt. We had him on at the beginning of the season to tell us the direction of the program, and now we're here. Unfortunately, maybe a little too soon, as he liked last night, was the end for Coach Knox Strawbridge's Forest High School soccer team. Hosted Atlantic Coast from Jacksonville, and not a familiar opponent. They hosted them in the regional quarterfinal for the playoffs. Lost 1-0. Quite unfortunate. Hit the post a couple times, had a lot of chances to put the ball in the net, but couldn't break through. Knox Strawbridge, welcome to the show. Thoughts from last night's game?
Well, first off, you put me a lot under a lot of pressure with calling me one of these fantastic guests. But
very popular.
Yeah,
Knox,
something
Strawbridge.
Like that. Thoughts from last night's game? Didn't quite get what we wanted. Obviously, being on the wrong end of a 1-0 game is always tough for the kids, and even as a coaching staff, it's a little frustrating because just one little thing can make a difference. And we weren't quite able to capitalize last night on some of our chances. And you got to give credit to Atlantic Coast for making it pay when we made a few little mistakes. We had a chance; we were down the field, almost had a goal, and in a blink of an eye, Atlantic Coast has backed down our throat and putting one in the back of the net.
It was a very even game. I was in attendance last night, freezing. I know you must have been as well. Very cold. Not as much wind as you saw at Eastridge whenever you played Vanguard and beat Vanguard to win the district championship. But let's talk about that district championship. Finished the season 16-4-3 this year. Was it better than what you predicted at the beginning of the season?
I didn't set out with a lot of predictions for this year. I had some thoughts and had some ideas on what it could be. If you remember from way back when, I said, we're a little young, it's a little early, don't want to give them too much, but by the time it's all said and done, I think we may have a pretty good chance, and when you lose 1-0 in the opening round of the playoffs, every team at this stage, for us at our level, is going to be very, very tough, and so they made us pay. But when it comes down to district champs, I told the kids last night, especially the seniors leaving, There has been a lot of talent that has come through Forest High School playing boys soccer that can never say that they won two district champs, much less back-to-back. So that's something they absolutely need to be proud of, something that they should, be able to look back and be proud of at the end of the day.
Well, let's look at it from a different perspective. Let's say the 1-0 loss was actually a 1-0 victory, which last season you won three games in a row in the playoffs, all 1-0, and then Fleming Island beat Vanguard last night. You would have to play Fleming Island Tuesday?
Tuesday night, yep. That's when the
you played Fleming Island earlier this season. You think you could have, and you drew to them at their place. You would have to play them anyways at their place. You think this could have gone a little bit longer?
Well, it could have been really fun. Could have been really, I told the boys before the game, tonight's going to be really, really close, and it's going to come down to something little, and you got to stay disciplined and stay after it all game. Fleming Island, poor Vanguard. Fleming Island is a really, really good team. They're it's really like running into a buzzsaw when you're going to play them.
Fleming Island beat Vanguard 7-0, and Vanguard also suffered an injury to their best player and a red card.
Yeah. On one of the... Almost, yeah. Vanguard, or playing Fleming Island would have been tough to go into their place again. You know, 1-1 tie, definitely for the season, when, you know, you got to give credit to our boys for getting the 1-1 tie early in the season. I think it would have been another very tight game. Fleming Island's got a lot of talent, and I think it would have been interesting if we had been able to get Matt Lopez back for Tuesday night. He wasn't able to play last night. You know, one of your senior captains, it's always tough to lose. Especially when you're trying to gear up for a good playoff run.
Now, you have only been coaching, like I said before, for 2 years. And at the first season, there was a lot of question marks, like, who is this young guy bringing in all his friends from when he formerly played at Forest? But the success has been the best in school history at Forest. And Forest has a lot of tradition, a tradition of winning in multiple sports. How are you achieving this much success so soon in your coaching career?
Well, you say I've only been coaching for 2 years. Some of my coaches that were my coaches when I was growing up playing might have been saying I've been coaching a little longer than that. always had
Peyton Manning on the field for soccer.
Try to be. Certainly not at that level. But just been around the game a long time. Been able to understand, been able to communicate with the kids, and try and really break it down for them and get to the basics of, you know, what are the essentials that we really need to work on and focus on, and get down to really those basics and focus on those, and then, you know, extrapolating those to, okay, how does this work big picture? Where do we need to move? How do things work? And really trying to get the kids to understand the game instead of just, like Coach Jody Phillips calls it, playing kickball.
Exactly. So looking forward, I know you don't want to look forward to next season already. I understand that. But next season, you have a lot of sophomores on the team from this year and some key juniors. Who are some players that we can look to next winter and say, wow, these are some really good players filling in the roles for the seniors that graduated?
Yeah. First off, I mean, you got to give great credit to the kids we had this year for filling in. When you look at the team last year compared to this year, I mean, I could really say you only had two kids that started or guaranteed starters last year. That started this year. We had a few other guys that were started every now and then and played a
rotational
fair amount of minutes.
Players.
Yeah, but when you talk about really the starting 11 we had this year, you know, we were basically fielding almost a whole new team. So forging a little new identity, and then so this year, you know, we'll lose some seniors that we are really going to miss, and then some of the young guys we got coming back are going to be a lot of fun. You know, Daniel Ware is only a freshman. But he scored, I think, like 10 goals for us from the middle and had a number of assists. Nazar Deputat in there is a sophomore. Obviously, you got Tyler, who led the team, and Tyler Stanville up top, who led the team in scoring. And then on the back end, Jack Pavilion, our goalkeeper, was only a sophomore. And Harris Cannon, our sweeper, or our center back, was only a sophomore. So we got a lot of young talent and even some guys that weren't quite able to crack the lineup this year, you know, expecting some of those guys to really step up again next year and prove that, you know, they're really ready for it. So we got a lot of guys that got some good experience this year and looking to build upon that for the future.
You're listening to Knox Strawbridge, the Forest High School head soccer coach. This is Josh LaSelva with the High School Athletic Spotlight. In Marion County, football will always be one of the biggest sports that we have.
Without a doubt.
But there's a lot of secondary sports that come in with swings of popularity. We see it with baseball, soccer now maybe, basketball. Do you think soccer is seeing that potential popularity drift?
Oh, I think absolutely. I mean, I think, in the really about the early 90s, when kind of the soccer craze started, you're starting to see some of those early to late 90 kids really growing up that have been playing since they were little. So the talent pool is really getting deeper, and, there's kids that are really out there competing. And so I think that's why you're seeing a popularity swing is there's kids that are getting good. You know, when you look at Trinity Catholic girls the last few years, you got to give credit to that. And then the Forest girls this year and our boys the last couple years, there's definitely talent out there. And I think it mostly just extends from those kids, you know, playing since they were little and, you know, falling in love with the game. Not really different than any other sport, but, you know, you get good at it and your friends want to get good at it, and then you're playing in the street and in the yard, and, you know, next thing you know, it's just like breathing. So,
especially when now Ocala is home to the Ocala Stampede, which
That's
is starting
right.
up in the summer. I know you're very excited about that. Talk to me a little about the Stampede. What's your role over there?
I I don't have an official capacity with them necessarily. I coach a 15-year-old boys club team, kind of in partnership with them. The Ocala Stampede is a basically what we would kind of call a semi-professional league, very similar to what you know, AAA baseball and things like that that play in the summer. College guys, other guys that are kind of ex-professionals or ex-pros trying to get back into the game, or are coming from overseas trying to get an opportunity. You know, they've sent about, I want to say six or seven at least, probably to the professional level over the last 2 years. They've won their division the last couple of years, so. You know, we'd love to have some more support on the soccer side, and especially for the, you know, the Stampede to kind of crank that up and keep that stuff going, because really they've kind of become the top of the structure in the soccer world in Marion County, and we always want to support them. So,
you obviously love soccer. I can just tell with your enthusiasm right now. World Cup, USA, do they have any chance this summer of progressing from the group stages? You got Portugal, help me out here, Portugal, Germany, and
Ghana,
yeah. Who's knocked us out in the past two World Cups.
Yeah, they're calling it probably the group of death. You know, when you get to the World Cup, you're talking about 32 of the best teams from around the world. So the competition level is really very elite. You know, what I love about being American, you know, is we really do have a never give up attitude, and we're going to fight till the bitter end. I think we've got a great coach who's done some really awesome things and has been able to combine a little bit of our, you know, work hard, stay tough mentality, and also trying to help some of our players really understand the game and, you know, just be able to compete at that level. And
Jurgen Klinsmann has done a phenomenal job.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think we got a chance. You know, I think it'll come down to a little bit of, we will have to rely on our athletics a little more. We got some better athletes. You know, some of those other countries have fantastic soccer players. But when it comes down to it, we might be able to make a few more athletic plays, and I think that's going to pay off for us in the long run. So, you know, stick to that and then continue to combine that with what we're trying to do on the field, and I think it's a pretty awesome combination. So it'll be fun to watch, that's for sure.
Knox Strawbridge, it's a pleasure joining us on the show. One last question before we go. Super Bowl 48, who you got?
Man, as much as I just do not like Tennessee, you know, it's really hard to root against Peyton Manning. He's just fun to watch because it's fun to watch anybody that, you know, understands the game like that. And you just get to sit there and watch, you know, the orchestra conductor just sit there and, you know, kind of do his thing.
And not have to worry about it.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. So, you know, I think Seahawks are going to give him a run. But I think at the end, I'd love to see Peyton win one more. So.
You're a smart man. I have Denver by 10. Thank you for joining us. Always a pleasure.
Absolutely.
Good luck to you.
Thank you, Josh.
Next season as well. Tom Schmitz, that's all we got. Poor hosting, phenomenal guest.
I don't know about that.
You've been trained well by Buddy Barton and myself then. Hey, we're going to take a break. When we come back, Joe Williams from Mile High Sports joins us right here on Buddy Sports Page on Community Gazette Day, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
If you didn't catch Around the Water Cooler, here's what you missed.
You're at the media day. You're going to talk to a player where the questions are so boring and innocuous that they're tired of answering them. You're going to talk to a player, an intelligent question, hope to get a good response. And I would ask Manning, what was it like the first day you picked up that football and could not throw it? How much fear was in your heart that your career was over?
Mm-hmm.
And look where he is now. That's the story I would want to know about. But I'm sure he'll be asked that by anybody. But that's what I would ask.
Around the Water Cooler, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 5 o'clock on Buddy's Sports Page.
Dr. Seaborn Hunt, a board-certified ophthalmologist, is your comprehensive medical, laser, and surgical eye care specialist for Marion, Lake, and Sumter counties. He offers services for cataract surgery, diabetes, glaucoma, macular degeneration, dry eyes, as well as a routine comprehensive eye exam. Call 873-7200 for an appointment today. No referral needed. Dr. Hunt accepts Medicare as well as most insurance plans and files the claims for you. Dr. Hunt has performed thousands of successful procedures. Call Dr. Hunt at 873-7200. That's 873-7200.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leading leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. We're in Florida. Today, cloudy with a little rain and drizzle at times, high 68 to 72. Tonight will be mostly cloudy with a chance of a shower early, then some clearing late tonight. Lows ranging from 59 inland to 65 on the beaches. Tomorrow may start with areas of fog, otherwise clouds and some sunshine and warm with a chance of a shower, high 77 to 81. Sunday, partly sunny and warm, high 78 to 82. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, welcome back to Buddy Sports Page. Time now to go all the way out to Denver, where there's a football team playing in a Super Bowl out east, as they say, there in the Rocky Mountains. And the guy who tried to run John Elway out of town a long time ago and failed now finds himself in the awkward position of having to cheer for him. And I hope, Joe Williams, that you will put that jersey on, number 7, that I bought you, and watch the game.
Well, I don't have it. It doesn't fit me anymore. I can pass up too many buffets. Sorry.
That was a great day when I made you put that jersey on. We had our picture made with it. I'm wearing mine Sunday, by the way. Mine
well,
does
be a great
fit.
Great day for some, not all.
Yeah. Well, speaking of which, a good point by Rick Riley in his column that Elway could become the first MVP of a Super Bowl to actually win a Super Bowl as an executive as well. So that's pretty impressive. Even you have to admit that's pretty impressive.
I don't know about that. Riley, by the way, once hired by you to the Denver Post from the Boulder Camera.
Well, in a moment of weakness.
He's gone on to bigger and better things, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. We should all have gone on to bigger and better things like he did, for sure. But
I think the Broncos are going to run into some problems here.
Well, why do you say that? Well, you know what you are? Some people are rainmakers. You're a guy who likes to rain on parades.
No, I can't help it. It's just the way, as you used to read the corn, the corn stalks from Denver to Greeley on the way to Greeley.
Yes, I did.
It is whatever it said it was.
Now, why do you want to go and say that now, just to mess up this whole thing for the Denver fans?
Well, it's like, you know, some people read tea leaves and others read those goofy cards. And just my instincts tell me that the problem is here in this game, it isn't who you think's the best team. The number, the betting line number, is not right. That's why it gives me cause for concern for Denver, because Denver's been favored, you see, in 30 straight games. They've been favored. Every time they go out on the field, they're favored, it seems like. And most of the time, double-digit favorites. And most of the time they win by double digits. Now all of a sudden they're playing against a team that can't score touchdowns, can't get any points. They never score more than seems like 20 or 22 or 3. Denver is a team that averages 40, and they're only a 2.5-point favorite. Does that add up? See, things have to add up. You know,
well, what are you saying?
Right, wrong, logic, it has to add up. The numbers don't add up. That's why I'm worried about this.
Well, speak to me about this, about the Broncos, who open as a 2-point underdog and now are 2.5-point favorites. Obviously, people think they're the better football team. Obviously, they all are impressed with what Manning did. Obviously, that defense, which wasn't that good early in the season, is better. I don't think you should take Seattle lightly. Don't get me wrong. Some people might be doing it. I'm not taking them lightly. But I think it'll be a one-point game. But what's not to like about Denver right now?
It's not Denver. It's the number. The number is not right. Everything's to like about Denver. Their defense has been playing pretty good. The two playoff games, they did very well against San Diego, and they did very well against a depleted New England team. It has two white wide receivers that can't time them with a sundial, but still, they had Tom Brady. I understand all that. But, you know, the number is not right. Why are they not favored by 5 or 6 or 8 or 9 points?
Seattle is a good football team.
When the number came out, Seattle was a very slim choice. The public, of course, took over immediately, and 75% of the money in the sports books in Las Vegas went to Peyton Manning. But I can guarantee you, well, almost guarantee you this, all of you back down there in Florida, you remember you heard this, because you'll be reading about it on, either Sunday. They'll talk about it before the game, prior to the game, or afterwards. But that number that's 2.5, that number's going to come down. Because the wise guys in Vegas, they don't bet teams, they bet numbers. And they know that number's not right, just like I know that number's not right. And that number's going to come down. So we'll see what's what when they kick the thing off.
I don't disagree with you. I think it'll be a one-point game at kickoff, in my opinion. And I think people got enamored with the Broncos and then Peyton Manning's story. But let me just say this. You know that more amateurs bet the Super Bowl than any other event. You know, there's a lot of guys out there that are watching line like you are, and they're going to pound it on Sunday, the wise guys are, and they're going to probably end up taking Seattle.
Well, the wise guys are going to bet Seattle.
Yeah.
Historically, they're looking for the points anyway when they can get them, if they see the value in them. And the public, of course, they can bet the money, but they don't necessarily move the line. That's not what's coming up, because the public's going to bet $100 million in Las Vegas. There'll probably be $1 billion bet illegally in the United States that's not taxed by anybody or anything like that. And that's why those bookmakers drive Mercedes and you and me drive Chevy Bel Airs.
We'll talk with Joe Williams of My High Sports. Joe, Tom Schmitz here. I agree with you 100%, and I'm taking Seattle in this game, but you're right. With Denver being a 40-point on average team, Seattle being a 25-point average, that's
right.
A 14-to-15-point difference. For this game to only be 2.5, that is really, really suspicious. And that's what you're saying. With a 14-point difference, this should be at least half of that, maybe. A 7 of that 14 points should be what Denver's favored.
That's right, Tom. That red flag should go right up the flagpole down there in Ocala and every place else and sticking straight out, telling everybody, you better look out, you better watch out. This Peyton Manning story has got everybody by the cross in the crosshairs, and you're going to end up with your hand on your wallet, or maybe somebody else's hand in your wallet.
Well, then you can say I told you so. Let me ask you about another subject.
Well, what I told them was don't come crying to me.
I know you told them. I'm sure you did. Let me ask you this question, Joe.
By the way, that's a line that you wrote for me a long time ago.
I did, and I've regretted it ever since then, by the way. I do want to ask you for your final score. Then I want to ask you a basketball question.
All right.
Score, please, on the Super Bowl.
Let's go 20-17, Seattle.
20-17, Seattle. Well, we're close. All right. This past weekend, or 2 days ago, the Heat and OKC went head-to-head. And your man,
who I think you were one of the first ones to jump on the Durant bandwagon, who he lit it up. He had a phenomenal game. And everybody's saying now the comparison between the two superstars, Durant and LeBron, is real close now. In fact, in the game, I think Durant scored 33, and I believe LeBron scored 34. But
yeah, they were close in numbers, yeah.
But the amazing thing was watching the tape of that. Durant got some shots off of me from all kind of places that just hit nothing but net. Right now, has Durant narrowed the gap between him and LeBron, and will there come a time, although I think LeBron's a better defender, and Durant's not bad, by the way. I think we'll be talking about this guy in the same breath. Do you think so?
This is how they measure him in the NBA. They measure him with rings. You know that. Tom knows it. I know it. Everybody knows it. Until Durant gets rings, he's finishing second in the field of two. He's got to get rings. The regular season doesn't mean beans in the NBA. We all
know. You always said to me that you passed the eye test, and since you have one good eye, you said you can see when somebody's better, somebody's good, and somebody's not good. Your eyeball test on Durant, how good is this guy?
Well, how do you know that technology hasn't improved my other eyeball? Maybe I can see how to do it now.
That's possible. And your brain could be next. That would be great.
Hey, Durant, I mean, he obviously is a very, very extremely talented player. Well, one of the greatest that's come along in the last 10 or 15 years. And, yes, I loved him coming out of college, and he hasn't done anything to disappoint me. I'm just saying you can't mention him with LeBron until he takes care of the hardware. That's all I'm saying.
All right, fair enough. Okay, Joe Williams calls it 2017 Seattle. We'll talk to you next week. It's been Joe Williams of Mile High Sports in Denver. Thanks, Joe.
Fellas, have a good time this weekend, and stay out of the Cheetos.
Okay, Joe. All right, I want to thank Joe Williams, of course, and earlier Knox Strawbridge on with Josh LaSalva. Tom Ingram was our guest. Jim Ross, a new managing editor of the Ocala Star Banner. And earlier than that, we had Carmen and Cesar Soto coming to remind us of the special events at the Marion, including Sunday's Super Bowl game. That's where we're going. We're going to be there. Come see us on Sunday night. On behalf of my broadcast partner, Tom Schmidt, Josh LaSalva, and Austin the Statman Tatman, I'm Buddy Martin. Have a terrific weekend, everybody.
She grew up in an Indiana town, had a good-looking mom who never was around, but she grew up tall and she grew up right with them Indiana boys on an Indiana night.
You know, Austin, I'm sitting here at the computer looking at our Facebook page, and boy, we really need to tell more listeners about our Facebook page.
No, Tom, see, you got it all wrong. Twitter is the new age.
What's a tweeter?
No, a Twitter, Tom. The voice of Ocala has a...